رسوله النبي الكريم، ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين، والحمد لله رب العالمين. My dear respected listeners, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, out of His extreme mercy, sent upon us the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the most perfect Sharia, a way of life that was shown to us practically by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and advised to us, that contains the recipe for our success, eternal success. In this Sharia, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us through the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran, and through his Sunnah, different kinds of ibadat, different kinds of things which we have to do and which we have to refrain from. And among the do's, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has told us some that are a right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by virtue of us being His creations, by virtue of us being His ibad. Someone who was created and who is constantly being sustained by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And those are fara'id and wajibat. Those are a right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a right of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us by virtue of us being the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But there are others, and many more others, which are called mustahabbat and nawafil, which are the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has loved us so much, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has specialized the humankind for His love. These are called the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the right of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned in one hadith that these nawafil, if a person keeps on doing them, they attain such a level where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes their hand and becomes their vision. So basically, the meaning of the hadith is that through excessive nawafil, reading excessive nawafil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides and takes into control and illuminates with His noor all the capacities of a human being. Among these nawafil, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, afdal, the best, in terms of salah, afdal as-salah, ba'd al-maktubat, wa ba'd al-fara'id, aw kama qala alayhi salatu wassalam, is the night prayer, standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, at night time, alone, where everyone else or most of the other people are enjoying deep slumber. Hazrat Fuqaha have written that why is this night prayer a specially beloved act to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The core reason behind it is that everything that contains sacrifice, the more sacrifice it contains, the more beloved it becomes in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So at night time, when everyone else is sleeping, and when it is generally a time for us to be asleep, we leave our warm bed and we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really loves this act. This act, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala really pleases, this act really pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that when a third of the night has passed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the closest sky of the sky that closest to the earth. That sky which is the closest to the earth. Now what is the reality of this descent? We do not know. It is according to the status of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we as creations have no capacity to fully understand Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala nor His sifat, nor His qualities. So how that happens and what is the real meaning of that? The Muhaddiseen have explained that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes really attentive towards the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are calling upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a lot of people with my Shaykh, Dr. Mufti Imran Haq Al-Yami, and through me as well, they try to come and ask us about increase in their worldly risk, their worldly provision. There's very few who are actually concerned about their akhirah as well, that we need to change our life in a way that we become those that enter Jannah. The Prophet ﷺ in this hadith has given a perfect remedy for this, a perfect solution for these problems. Prophet ﷺ has said that when the third of the night has passed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the sky that is closest to the earth, and a caller calls out on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is there anyone who seeks maghfirah that I give them maghfirah? So that I could give them maghfirah. Imagine the creator of all the world, the creator of all the rizq, is himself coming closer to us and asking us, is there anyone who needs these things? And we are sleeping, heedless. Then that caller calls out, is there anyone who needs rizq? Who needs rizq? Provision. And rizq, Hazrat ulama have explained, I'm pretty sure I have explained it before here as well, that rizq does not only include your worldly food or worldly money, but it also includes your ruhani rizq, your elevation in terms of your batin, your progress in terms of your deen, your progress in terms of becoming closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rizq includes that as well. So a caller calls out on behalf of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself calls out, is there anyone who seeks rizq, that I give them rizq? So I give them rizq. If there's anyone who is in a calamity and seeks ease out of that calamity, I would give them ease out of that calamity. Now we should understand, the matter of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not the matter like we have. Even in human beings, when somebody themselves goes out asking people, they definitely want to give that to people. The Creator is such, you know, whenever somebody asks us something and we do not give it to them. For example, somebody asks me for money and I refuse them. Why do I do that? There might be two reasons for it. Either, number one, I do not have what they are asking, right? I do not have what they are asking. They ask me for $100, I do not have $100. The other reason may be that I am, na'uzu billah, a miserly person. Even if I have the money, I don't want to give it to them. Or, I have the money, but I want to use it for my own purposes because I need that money. These three things do not apply to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, neither Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala needs that thing for himself, Nor Allah subhanahu wa, there is ever a chance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has run out of that thing, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have that thing. Nor is it that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, na'udhu billah, hasha wa billah, is a miserly being. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is miserly. Neither of these things apply to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in general, at any time of the day, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for sure grants that dua. For sure grants that dua. That is a different story. We may realize it, we may not realize it. That is a different story. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on his part for sure grants that dua. But imagine the next step. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the giver, is himself descending closer to us and asking us himself, is there anyone who needs, who has needs basically pertaining to their akhirah, who has needs basically pertaining to their world, who has immediate needs in terms of being in a calamity, I will grant that to him. I will grant that to them. Whatever they ask at this time. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there's several hadiths to this effect, where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because this is not a first, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not strictly advise of it, but the very next level is that the Prophet ﷺ, the strongest encouragement that the Prophet ﷺ has given is about nighttime prayer. Our Grand Sheikh Dr. Abdul Hisab Arifi rahimahullah has said that even if you are not able, and this is actually proven from hadith, the Prophet ﷺ has said that any salah after Isha, it will be considered a part of nighttime prayer. So if we are tired, although the best time is to do it in the last part of the night, or if we divide it into three parts, the time from Isha to Fajr, the Isha to the start of Fajr, if we divide that time into three, the best part, the ulama have said, is the middle third. And if we divide it into two, the best part is the second half. The best part is that. But if we are not able to do that, we should at least make a habit that after the sunnah of Isha and before the Witr Salah, we should at least pray two rakat. It is expected from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will get the share in Tahajjud. And Hakim al-Ummat, Mawlana Shaykh Al-Thani, rahimahullah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless him and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill his grave with nur. He has said, his style, subhanAllah, even the people who are the farthest away from Deen, even the people who would have no energy to act on Deen, he would find some solution even for them. So he has said that if you, and it happens generally, that we do, for some reason, for one or reason or the other, we do break our sleep during the night. For example, to go to the bathroom, or even, you know, we just wake up for a bit and then we go back to sleep again. He has said that if that happens to you, only for a second, imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself is calling out after me at this time. And he's asking me that, do you need rizq? I will give you rizq. Do you need maghfirah? I will give you maghfirah. Are you in any calamity? Are you in any suffering? I will ease your suffering. Even if you are not able to get up for salah, even if you do not have the energy to go to the bathroom and make wuzu, just sit up and raise your hands and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the least that you can do. And also use that opportunity to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, Ya Allah, this happens to me a lot, that I wake up at this time and I only make dua to you. I do not find the energy to actually get up and pray. Give me that energy. Give me that energy. If you constantly keep on doing that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like I said, has never ever is there a chance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is either miserly or has run out of his khazain, has run out of his treasures. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will definitely grant that to us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a decision, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put an effect of whatever has been said and heard in the hearts of the Quran. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.